Louisiana shit. Murder on the beat.
So my first DIY was inspired by this really cute art print from Urban, and it has really minimalist drawings, and I loved it, so I decided to mix the shoe, and I just used a drawing pad from one of my art classes, but it's super super easy to find them. Michaels have them anywhere, and I just traced the good vibes only and the lettering I wanted, and then I just traced it over it with a black marker to look like the print, and then it was basically it. It was super super easy, it looked super super cute. So something else I found nonstop on their website were these really cute art prints that they had in all sizes, all colors, all everything. So I decided to make them. They're super simple. And I got these magazines from a thrift store, but you can use any that you have laying around your house. And I wanted my art prints to all be matching, so I wanted all of them to have blue tones. So when I flipped through the magazines, I looked for images that had bluish tones. And please be careful not to rip the pages, because that's what I did 100 times, so be careful. If you don't find the pictures you want, you can always print them out like I did, and they're super super cute. So I wanted to use this colorful washi tape that they have on their photos, but after going to Target 3 times and every time forgetting about buying them, I decided to just DIY them, because this is a DIY channel. So I just took some normal tape and painted it with acrylic paint, and that's basically it. It was super easy and it looked pretty legit. Watch the breakdown. And I added some Polaroid pictures that I DIY'd in my last video, so if you haven't seen that, I'll link it down below. So a lot of their art prints on the website were pulled by this thing called Bulldog Clip, and I actually had one laying around in my house, and I clipped it into my magazine cutout to hang it, and it looked super super cute. And I know they may seem super unnecessary, but they do look cute once you hang them, I promise that. And I'll leave some links down below if you want to buy them. So these vintage maps were everywhere on their website, so I thought I could recreate them because they're super super cute and easy to make. And the magazines that I showed earlier had some maps, but laying around my house I also had this New York subway map and also my school campus map, so I thought it could be really cute to combine them. It's super personal, and you can even put some little things around the maps that remind you of the places you went. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and thumbs up.